Hey everybody, welcome back to another vlog. When I first started these vlogs, back towards, I don't know what, a couple of months ago now, I think, I meant them as a kind of a light-hearted kind of look at some of the news in the week, some events which may have happened in my life. Just a general kind of, I don't know, chit chat as we go through. But would it be wrong, I guess, of me not to mention the events of last Wednesday, the 22nd of March? For those of you who don't know, I live in London. I have done for about 6 years now, and I like it here. I guess you wouldn't live anywhere for 6 years if you didn't like it. I mean, maybe you wouldn't have a choice for reasons, but I like it. I grew up in the countryside, but and I do miss that. But the city is it's an amazing city. Last Wednesday, on the 22nd of March, unfortunately, there was a terrorist attack in the city. I believe five people were killed in this. I guess, for want of a better word, a lunatic decided to drive a car along a pavement along Westminster Bridge and then stabbed a police officer. Really quite kind of shocking events. The first I found out about the events, I was at work at the time. I work probably about maybe a 20 25 minute bus ride, tube ride from Westminster itself. I live more, oh, sorry, work more north than of the river than Westminster is. And we actually got an email come through because where I work in a cinema, for those who don't know. We kind of stay in contact with the police, and they email out when things happen to places which could potentially have incidents in them. Anywhere which has a large number of people congregate are obviously dangerous. Well, not necessarily dangerous, but at risk, shall we say. So yeah, an email came through. I read it. I was about an hour from finishing work, and obviously then checked my phone, and obviously we're reading about the reports of what happened. And yeah, just shocking, really, events. There's not much that I can say that a lot of other people haven't said in a lot better terms. The sad thing is that it's one of those attacks which, and I think the police and the intelligence services, MI5, MI6 in the UK, do an incredible job where at, keeping civilians from harm's way. A tough job, and it is incredibly sad that when something like this happens. And but it is one of those incidents where it's incredibly hard to predict or to stop or just have any kind of basis on it, I don't pretend to be an expert on any of this, but it's essentially one of those things where it doesn't take the planning or skills, I guess, that would happen, for other attacks, but and it can just happen from anywhere. And it's incredibly sad that there are people who will do this, to innocent people. A lot of people, I believe, a lot of people injured were just tourists visiting the city, on holiday or on school trips, things like that. And it's really horrible. But London, Something which you may be, I mean, you may be aware of, you may know, you may not know. London, it's kind of a unique city. It is probably the most culturally diverse city there is in the world. It has so many people of different nationalities, different religions, different cultures, that it is just this giant kind of melting pot. And in some ways, it's a model city in so much as it works. People get on, you know. It's hard to explain. There's always going to be, you know, you can always have 99.99% of people who are fine and get on with everything, and you're always going to have that small percentage who don't, who just don't like it. And London is the type of city where it is that case. But when there's 7 million people, that's a lot of people who get on, and not that many people who don't, really, I don't think. And one of the reasons why London gets targeted is because of that, is because it's so diverse, because it's a kind of a beacon to say that actually people of different religions, different cultures, different backgrounds, they can get along. There's no need for segregation. There's, you know, people of different races can live together in cities, and there's no problem with that. Everybody just gets on with their lives. You know, it's a city which has had to put up with a lot of attacks over the years. It, you know, even if you go back, I guess, fairly far, but back to World War II, it was nearly bombed to smithereens by the Luftwaffe. But, you know, the people of London, they persevered and they rebuilt. During the 70s, 80s, 90s, there was a lot of attacks via terrorist groups such as the IRA. And then as we came into the 21st century, the 2000s, it's moved more to the kind of extremist end. But one thing I will say is there's been a lot less attacks. As I said, the intelligence services, the police, have been doing an amazing job. For those of you who don't know as well, London, we don't have, in the UK, guns are illegal. It's illegal to own a gun. Most police officers don't carry any firearms whatsoever. There are armed police in London, mainly around like high risk targets such as the Houses of Parliament, airports, etc. But it's very, very rare for police officers who are armed to actually discharge their weapons. And it's kind of one of those things where living in London, you see that just everybody gets on, you know. There's so much diversity in different cultures that is celebrated all the time. And the idea of these attacks is to destabilize that, for people to turn on each other, for people to, you know, to fear their neighbors. But it doesn't work. It genuinely doesn't work. I went home from work maybe an hour after the incident last Wednesday, and there was really no difference to anything. There was no change in people. You might say, oh, that's, you know, heartless or whatever, there's been a terrible attack. But the genuine truth of it is that the idea of those attacks are to try and destabilize life, are to make people, to try and take away that freedom that people have, to have them live under a sense of, you know, terror, and to take away that, you know, the fact that everybody gets along. And they, you know, people in London just don't let that happen. They just, you know, they know that this is the work of just, you know, basically lunatics. And they get on with it. You know, we've seen it time and time again, across, you know, when it's been attacked before. And the horrible thing is, it will probably happen again. It's terrible when these things happen. I can even go into ways in which we can stop them, but one way that I know would not help would be to segregate or to change the way in which we run this country, because it just doesn't work. The UK could be changing at some point with Brexit and things like that. We'll have to wait and see on that one. But London will always be just a huge kind of multicultural city, and it will always stay that way as well. And that's what's kind of great about it as well. You know, if it was just, you know, it would make no sense to change that about the city. And certainly these attacks, they don't do anything to stop that at all. So I don't know if there's winning or losing in anything like this, because it feels to me like everybody loses, really. It's not, you know, the nicest thing to even have to talk about on camera. It's very sad events that's happened, but the genuine truth of the matter is that, and other people who maybe live in major cities which have had attacks as well may feel the same way, they may not, I don't know, but for me it doesn't feel like things change. It sounds weird, that the more it happens the less it matters. What I mean by that is, when you have these, you know, I think going back was probably when we had the attacks on the tube and buses, and unfortunately a lot more people died that day, and it's shocking. And then you have other things happen, and it's shocking, but it's like it kind of desensitizes you to it, and it's kind of horrible in a way, but it also is a way of people coping and moving on and getting on with their daily lives, because you can't let, you know, it affect you in that way. You just have to keep going, because otherwise that's exactly what they want to achieve by doing things like this. They want to, you know, effectively they want, you know, people to hate Muslims, and things like that, and it's just not the case in any way, sense or form. I don't want to get into politics or anything like that, because it's not even about that anymore. It's just about a military group who want to try and recruit people, and they think that this is the way they're going to do that, and to also, you know, try to split and divide their enemy, or the people they see as their enemy, when you know, it just doesn't work. So that's kind of what I wanted to say on that, really. As I said, it's incredibly sad, the events of what happened, but you know, the truth of the matter is that I live, even where I live, there's people all around me of different races, different cultures, different religions. Everyone gets on and just gets on with their daily lives, and as much as newspapers may want to report different things about, you know, the city being shut down, it was not the case in any way. It's laughable, really. And you know, it's been, from the time of me recording this, 6 days since the attack, and nothing's changed. So in some ways, I guess that's good. Obviously, no one forgets, you know, no one forgets the work of the emergency services, or, you know, the first responders. You know, I think, you know, people spoke more eloquently about things than I can, but they talk about the people when, you know, the people who don't run away from this, the people who run towards the danger. You know, a police officer lost his life due to this as well, and you know, it's incredibly sad when people are, you know, they do their job to protect people and ultimately pay the ultimate price for that job. It's a job I couldn't do, and you know, a lot of people have different views about the police and things like that, but ultimately it's, you know, unless you do the job yourself, or, you know, have done the job, I don't think you can really are in a position to turn around and say, you know, what it's like. I certainly couldn't judge, because, you know, that's not something I'd want to have to be a part of that day. It'd be pretty horrible. So yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to say really about that as a whole. A dark day, but as I said, you know, the sun rises the next day and people get on with their lives, and it's the way that they respond that makes the difference on days like this. And yeah, you know, I hope it never happens again. I think in the back of my head I realize that it probably will, which is sad. Although, as I said before, a lot less has happened within the last 17 years than happened before that, because of technology and things like that. More emphasis on combating this, I guess, which is great. So yeah, that's it really. As I said, I don't want to make these sort of vlogs turn into anything political or anything like that, because there's a lot of people out there who know a lot more about that sort of stuff than me, who, you know, you can find and listen to and talk about things like that. Because ultimately the problem is I just don't really care enough about politics and things like that to get involved in it. I always feel like it, I do care about politics in a way, but I just hate all the just stuff that goes with it, if you know what I mean. You know, I'm more of a facts person than a, you know, than anything else. So I guess the second thing I want to talk about really was just the way my week's going, because I'm actually on holiday now. So I've got a week off work, which is good. Just taking a week off, really not doing that much, which is nice. I don't generally go away on holiday very much. I always find it funny, the idea of, you know, working really hard, taking a holiday, and then all the hassle of coming with taking a holiday. So you know, having to go get your flights, you know, getting up really early, get a flight, you know, flying somewhere else, and then, you know, of course some people do have a relaxing time, other people have like a really like energetic time and a great time, admittedly, but come back probably even more tired than when they went away, which I always find a bit funny. But I generally just tend to relax and catch up on things which you know, I haven't had the time to do, or have little projects for myself to do to keep myself busy and just enjoy a nice relaxing time and recharge your batteries, I guess, away from work, which is really important to do, I think, all the time. But one thing I am getting back into is streaming now. I actually had like a couple of weeks off because I was a little under the weather, and there have been loads of like bugs going around everywhere, and I probably caught most of them, I think. And it wasn't too bad, like, don't get me wrong, I wasn't like, I didn't take any time off work. I've still managed to make videos, although I may have sounded a little bit bunged up on a lot of them. But something had to give, and that what gave was streaming. You know, for those of you who don't know, I generally stream about once a week, usually for about 3 to 4 hours. So it can be, I'm not going to try and use the term tiring, but it takes a lot of focus and concentration sometimes. And if you're a bit under the weather, like when I was recording videos, I'd be like, okay, I'm fine to record for half an hour, but, you know, then I'd take a break and do something else. And so for streaming, you know, I'd probably, I just thought, yeah, it's best if I just take a break. But I'm back now streaming. I just had a stream on Monday, did some Horizon Zero Dawn, really enjoyed it. And I figured I might as well just stream when I'm on holiday every night. Just, why not? So I figured I will, and just probably play something different each night. At some point I'm going to play some Skyrim. At some point I'll probably do some Zelda as well. nothing kind of like story based, but probably more exploration and discovery type stuff. And yeah, I may do some other games and things like that, which I haven't done in a while. Probably some Hearthstone as well, in there, because kind of like get myself back into it, because I really have not been playing very much Hearthstone recently. But the new update's coming through, and that's super cool. Or update, I say expansion is a better word, I guess. You have to excuse me, it's like 1 a.m. in the morning now. Although technically it's actually midnight, because we had British summertime come in, which meant the clocks went forward an hour, which really sucks because you lose an hour's sleep. But I guess it's necessary. It's a necessary evil. And then you do get it back later in the year. You get that hour back. So that's okay. So yeah, so you can catch the streams if you want to. Generally, I think gonna start about 10 p.m. BST each night, go for 2-3 hours, just see how it goes. And obviously I'll put all the videos up on the channel as well as we go. And just enjoy that really. And we've got some new things coming on the channel, I think. Some games I've been playing and enjoying. It's been crazy. Genuinely quite crazy actually, and surprised me, the response to Zelda. I mean, part of me, it always surprises me how popular Nintendo games are, because they're so difficult to, they're inaccessible, I would say. By that, what I mean is you have to have a Nintendo console to play them. So, for example, Zelda, you have to have a Wii U or Switch, and as we know, Wii U did not sell a lot, so chances are you don't have one of those. And the Switch is either really difficult to get hold of, or not that many people want to pay the money for a new console just to play one game. So maybe it shouldn't surprise me that it's so popular, because a lot of people maybe don't have the game or have no kind of thoughts on getting the game, and so just watch the playthrough instead. But obviously, if you compare it to like other AAA games like Mass Effect, I guess you can get that on PlayStation, Xbox, PC. I guess Horizon is another one, which is an exception, but the PS4 is clearly a very popular console, so it's a little different, but so far so good. And really, really enjoying all those games that we're playing, that I'm playing on the channel, which is great. So I think I'm going to finish up there. Thank you so much for watching. It's probably a bit of a shorter one than normal. We're going to have a real life ASMR come up on Thursday as well. I didn't do one last week just because after the events of Wednesday, I was going to record it in the evening, but I was just really bummed out, to be honest. So I didn't. But I got some ideas of what to do. So we're going to do another one on Thursday. And I'll catch you guys then. See you later.